Alright, now I'm gonna talk about the Cats of Cloud Nine. Okay. Now this one I had in my head for a few weeks, and then I finally made the art part of it, and I put it together, and now it's a notebook, and eventually a story. But right now I'm looking at the Cats of Cloud Nine. I'm looking at it. Well, obviously has some kind of an animal rights, direction. You can see it as a billboard in LA. That type of thing. So you're driving by, there's a billboard, and there's the cats. Be like, oh my God, that's my cat. And or where is my cat? He's not on Cloud Nine. So there you go. It'll be like, people will be like wanting to pay money to put their cat on Cloud Nine. So it does have kind of a fun potential. Also animal awareness, animal love awareness. We love our animals, we love our pets. And all varieties, breeds, it doesn't matter if they're a breed. We get a lot of that, it's like, oh my gosh, you're only a breed type of person. Hex you. Well, no. I believe we love all those animals, whether they're the breed or just a mixed variety, So it's about that. It's about the type of awareness. And also, when we bring it into that light, that fun light, it takes it away from the Yulin group. We got to take it away from the Yulin group and, put it into a Disney churn, a Disney style of entertainment, So yeah, I don't know. I'm seeing it as it could be a movie, even these Cats of Cloud Nine. It could also be Broadway play. Broadway musical, or a ballet, but when I'm looking at it on a billboard and I'm seeing all those people in the traffic, I'm just seeing like, wow, that would be a really good effect, that would wake up their awareness to animal compassion, animal care, thinking about our creatures, is your cat at home? How's it doing? So it has all of that. It's almost like you have to bring that synapse into their brain again, and say, well, I have a pet, I have a cat, I have a dog. And you hear people say that. They'll say they have a dog, and they say it that derogatory like that, like it's just a dog. Or they have a cat, and it's just a cat. And there's not really like a family event with that creature. They just have it as it's just something that goes with their house. They got a house, so they have a dog. They have a house, they have a cat. It's not something that's really that they are in love with. They don't love their animal, So it's all about that, so bringing it in, and they're young kids, and so there it is, Cats of Cloud Nine, you bring it in to them, and there's the cat, and go, oh my God, I like that one, I like this one, and even that, just I like that cat. That brings in a new approach into the brain and a new acceptance also of the other cats. Go, well, I really like all of them, And then there'll be the kid at school that says, I like all those cats plus all the others in the whole world, And so it just starts to compound. Get them out of the pound and let that compound, Our ability to have these animals that are They're there, they're in our witness, they're in our vision, they're in our brains, they're in our think thought. And it's that repetitive repetitive agreement. The repetitive agreement that yes, you know. And unfortunately, we are a follower syndrome society, and so these people have to follow. A lot of them have to follow because maybe their grandparents didn't. And my grandfather was terrible the way he talked about drowning cats. He was terrible. But that was the way they were back then. You know, they lived on farms and they couldn't have too many. It was just a bad thing. And nowadays we've gone beyond that. But with each generation, you know, those kids have to have that instillment. They have to have the instillment that, hey, you know, it's okay to love those cats. Go, I like the furry ones. I just like the hairless cats. I just like the cats that have really big manes, you know. So I mean, that, even that. Let them see those cats. And I do feel a little bit like a lot of the animal rights people are sidewinded into, okay, fine, you do some votes for it here or there, you click this, you click that, and then maybe they'll send you information and you get on their mailing list. And I see lots of cats. I see lots of dogs. I see bears, I see wolves, I see all kinds of things showing up in my mailbox. But that's because I took that first initial effort towards. Now, I don't believe the people are making that first initial effort. So when we get into the ad campaign, we have to hit the billboards. Do not forget the status of the billboard. It's very, very powerful. Don't forget the status of the movies. Movies have become diluted, though, a lot, because there are so many movies now, aren't there? So it really has to be a big hit. Like, I don't think Jessica Rabbit really helped rabbits. You know what I mean? What was that one? Some Jessica Rabbit movie. No, I don't think she helped the rabbits. But yeah, that's where we're at. As we have to get it in their vision, that acceptance. And you know, even if I am putting them on notebooks out there, or I'm gonna, you know, try to sell them out to kids to take to school, that's in their vision. And then the other kids is sitting next to them in school and going, hey, let me see that. Oh my gosh, that's my cat. My cat is just like that. And so guess what? You start making friends over that moment. Friends over just that notebook. So there's another way. We get the kids young and we make them develop friendships over those animal events. There are cats, there are dogs. I haven't made a dog one yet, but I will. But you know, oh my gosh. I love that one. I love that cat. It's my favorite cat on the whole earth. The whole planet. And all of a sudden there's communication, bavarde, going on between that kid and another kid, and they never talked before. All of a sudden, hey, broke the ice. So yeah, so don't diss my notebooks. I know they're bad, taking the forest a little bit. But they have higher potential. All right. So that's that. And I am writing a book. I am putting them into a book, my ancient histories, and but I can't get out of rhyming. I'm just stuck in rhyme. So what? So I'm gonna rhyme through the story. And I guess that's my habit, and I can't get out of it. Too bad. They will be pretty. They will be pretty collages. Probably about 40, 50 pages of story and notebook, but they take a long time. And yeah, so that's going to be, I think I'm on my second one already. But yeah, let's think about that with the animals. That dimension, bringing it into, because even the TV, just because they have a TV set, it doesn't mean they're clicking on the animal TV show. Doesn't mean that ever. It means possibly that at home they have a terrible father or a terrible mother that says, "No, you can't. I watch this in the afternoon, and no, you can't watch that." So maybe that medium is completely not given to that kid. So we have to get to that kid and make them appreciate the animals. All right. Rah.